assume that matter is totally unconscious, and that's where the problem arises. How does consciousness come out of something that is totally, absolutely unconscious? Consciousness is in everything. And the second bit is the opposite is also true. Everything is in consciousness. By which I mean, whatever we experience, whatever we know, is actually an appearance in the mind. When we look at the world, we know, and this is something science cannot deny, it looks at this a lot. The neurosciences explore this in great depth. In fact, it was really the beginning of psychology 150 years ago, experimental psychology, was looking at how the image in the mind relates to the world out there. We assume that's what happens. We know it's what happens. When you're, you know, looking at this world now, looking at the screen, looking at the room, we know what is going on is that light comes in through the eyes, hits the back of the retina, triggers electrochemical impulses which travel down nerve fibers to the back of the brain, where the brain very cleverly, in about a tenth of a second, puts it all together and says, this is what it looks like out there. The brain creates its own image of what is going on out there, and very cleverly ties that in with the sound it hears, the feeling of sitting in the seat, whatever else, and creates this wonderful three-dimensional hi-fi, surround sound, touchy-feely, virtual reality which we live in.
If you have a golf ball-sized consciousness, when you read a book, you'll have a golf ball-sized understanding. When you look out, a golf ball-sized awareness. And when you wake up in the morning, a golf ball-sized wakefulness. But if you could expand that consciousness, then you read the book, more understanding. You look out, more awareness, and when you wake up, more wakefulness. It's consciousness. And there's an ocean of pure, vibrant consciousness inside each one of us. And it's right at the source and base of mind, right at the source of thought, and it's also at the source of all matter.
There is no matter as such. All matter originates and exists only by virtue of a force which brings the particle of an atom to vibration and holds this most minute solar system of the atom together. We must assume behind this force the existence of a conscious and intelligent mind. This mind is the matrix of all matter.